Hello children, in the last video we already have discussed about this lesson, living things and non-living things. Even we have discussed what are living things and what are non-living things. Things which have the life are called as the living things. Things which do not have the life, those are called as the non-living things. Then how we are going to separate both? We are going to separate both living and non-living things depending upon the features. For example, living things are going to perform some features and even non-living things are going to perform some another features. So depending on this, we are going to separate the living things and non-living things. And even in the last class, we have learned the features of living things. And in this today's class, we will learn about the features of the non-living things. So in the living things, we had first, living things eat food. Okay, but in this non-living things, the first feature is they do not eat food. Non-living things, they do not want the food. As the living things will eat the food for their energy and for other activities, they need food for energy. But non-living things, they do not need any food to eat. Then next one is they do not breathe. Non-living things, they are not at all going to breathe. They don't have any respiratory organ or respiratory system. They can exchange the gas. When they are not living, they do not breathe also. Third one is they do not grow. When they don't eat food, they don't want any energy to perform some other activities, and even non-living things are not at all going to go for growth. For example, if I have a pen here, this is a non-living thing. It is not at all going to eat. It is not at all going to breathe out or inside, okay? But even it is not at all going to grow for any height, small length, higher than this or the taller than this or the shorter than this, because it's a non-living thing. If I see this one after 10 years also, its height will be same, even if its size will be same. Then they do not move. If I have a board here, till I use my energy, if I want to lift it from this place to another place, till I am going to do that activity, it is not at all going to move from one place to another place, because it's not having any legs, any hands to move from one place to another place. Then the non-living things, they do not move from one place to another place. And even they do not reproduce. I have a pen. After some years, this pen is not going to lay the eggs, or it is not going to give birth to this young babies. Non-living things, then that may be a sun, moon, or that may be a rock, that may be a hill or mountain. They are not going to give birth to the young ones, or they are not going to lay the eggs to give or to reproduce themselves. Like this, the non-living things are not at all going for reproduction. Then they do not respond to the change. There are so many non-living things in this room. If suddenly some change is going to happen surrounded by those things, they are not at all going to respond to the change. If I sing in front of this pen, it's not going to respond. If I scream in front of this pen or in front of this board, it's not going to respond. It will be the same how it is hanging. Because the non-living things, they do not have any senses to respond to the any change. So they will not go for a respond to change. Then they do not have any life cycle. Non-living things, as I told you, when we were born, we were small baby, then the adult, then the young and the aged and the death. Again afterwards, like this only life cycle will start again. Whoever have born, whoever they have given birth to some other babies, again they will be baby, adult, young one, and aged, and death. It will pass like this in a cycle, life cycle manner. But this pen is not going to produce another baby, and it will not come to the adult and young one and the aged, and this pen is not at all going to die because it's not having life. Then the non-living things are not at all going to perform any life cycle. Last one, if they have the do not have the life, they are not at all going to die also. Then what are the features of the non-living things? They do not eat food, they do not breathe, they do not grow, they do not move from one place to another place, they do not reproduce, they do not respond to the change, they do not have any life cycle, and they will not die also. Okay, now we got the clear picture about the features and the non-features of the living things and the non-living things. Then in next one is, in the living things, what type of living things are there? What they eat for their food? There are three types, like herbivorous, carnivorous and the omnivorous. Herbivorous means those are the animals or the insects or the birds which eat the plant products, only plant products, like elephant will eat only plants, and the rabbit will eat only plants for its survival. So like those animals, we call them as a herbivorous, as we call a pure vegetarian, isn't it? So like that animals, we call them as a herbivorous. The animals which eat only the plant products are called herbivorous. Then the animals which eat by killing other animals, the meat of the other animals and the flesh of the other animal, those are called as carnivorous. And last one is, some animals will be there, they will eat both. They will eat plant also and they will eat meat of the other animals also. So like those animals are called omnivorous. I hope now you got a clear picture that herbivorous, carnivorous and the omnivorous. Herbi means animals which eat only the plants and plant products. And carnivorous means animals which eat other animals' meat and the flesh. And omnivorous means there are some type of animals which eat both plant products also and the meat also. For example, human body. We eat both. Some person will eat the plant products, that whatever the vegetable, fruits or grains, these all he is going to eat. And even if you give him a non-veg also, he is going to eat the non-veg also. So like this, there may be a dog, cat, like this. Even those are also going to eat plant products also and the animal products also. So by this we are going to wind up today's class. Before winding, I want to give you homework. So these three questions, you have to write the definitions along with the examples. I hope you will do the homework, and in the next video we will discuss next one. Bye bye.